Here's how to get started using Google Wave. When you sign into Google Wave, you'll see four panels: the navigation panel, contacts panel, search panel, and the wave itself. Each wave is a shared space on the web where people can edit and reply anywhere, adding rich text and media to bring discussion right into the context of a project. To start a new wave, click the New Wave button. The first text you type becomes the title of the wave. When you're in edit mode, you'll notice that there's a formatting toolbar at the top. Right now, only you can see this wave. When you're finished with the message, click Done. To add other people to the wave, click on their contact info, search for their name, or type in their Google Wave address to add them to your contacts. You can even drag them straight from the contacts panel. If they're also online, they can start editing and replying in the wave, and you will see their typing live. Maximizing the wave panel gives you a little more room on the screen. To respond to a message, click the reply button, or mouse over the bottom edge and click there. If you want to respond in line, double-click and select Reply. You can also create a private reply to a message by clicking on the drop-down arrow in the corner. Only the people added to the private reply can see this part of the conversation. To edit any message, double-click and select Edit. You can add an image or other file by clicking on the paperclip. You can also paste in a YouTube link and embed the video right inside the wave. To create a link from one wave to another, find the wave to link to in the search panel and drag it onto your open wave. To delete a message, use the drop-down menu on the top right. You can add extensions like a yes, no, maybe gadget from the editing toolbar. To add others, click the extensions link in the navigation panel to browse through the set of featured extensions you can install. New messages are highlighted in green. Use the spacebar to move through unread messages quickly, or use playback to step through the history of a wave to see how it progressed. When you're done with your project, you can copy it out to a new wave and leave the discussion behind. These are just the basics to get you started, so take some time to explore and try it with your group.